Hello everyone, I am Ishika and you are watching the Law Informants channel. In this video, I will be discussing about the Disaster Management Act. So let's get started with the video. You all must be aware about the word disaster. Today, let's understand the meaning of this word. Disaster is defined in Section 2 Clause D of the Disaster Management Act. It is defined as a catastrophe, a calamity or grave occurrence in any area arising from natural or man-made causes. It can be by accident, by negligence, which leads to the destruction of the property, damage to or degradation of the environment. The Disaster Management Act 2005 is an act which was passed by the Government of India for the efficient management of disasters and other matters related to it. It came into effect from 23rd December 2005, but only and only after receiving the assent of the President of India. This act basically contains 11 chapters and 79 sections. It further provides for the constitution of different executive committee at national and state levels. Earlier we had only post-disaster leave, but now at present, at this time in this scenario, we have pre-disaster preparedness, mitigation and risk reduction. There are different ministers for different disasters, but Ministry of Home Affairs is the only nodal head of all the disaster management.
An important fact related to Disaster Management Act, that is, Health and Family Welfare manages biological disaster, Department of Atomic Energy manages nuclear disaster, Civil Aviation manages airplane related disaster, and Environment and Forest manages chemical disaster.
Now you must all be thinking that why was this act enacted, why it came into effect. So let's understand with it. Basically, this act was enacted to prevent, mitigate and prepare for the disasters, keeping in mind the following three major disasters in the Indian subcontinent. Firstly, the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami. Second, 1999 super cyclone in Odisha. Third, 2001 Bhuj earthquake. There are basically important provisions for this Disaster Management Act. The Act mandated the formation of the National Disaster Management Authority. It is the apex body with the Honorable Prime Minister of India as the chairperson, with other members not exceeding 9, including a vice chairperson. But tenure of all the members of the National Disaster Management Authority is 5 years. There are some of the key functions and responsibilities of this authority, like approve the national plan, approving plans prepared by ministers, India in accordance with the national plan. They also lay down some guidelines which is strictly to be followed by the state authorities in drawing up the state plan. Second important provisions which was being taken was State Disaster Management Authority. The Chief Minister of the state is the chairperson and the other 8 members are appointed by the Chief Minister. The responsibilities of the members of State Disaster Management Authority are that they prepare minimum standards of relief, they prepare disaster management policy, mitigation plans for various hazards, they also coordinate and monitor the implementation of national policies. Third, District Disaster Management Authority. The chairperson of this authority will be the collector or disaster magistrate or deputy commissioner of the district. The roles and responsibilities of District Disaster Management Authority have been elaborated in Section 30 of the Disaster Management Act 2005. The key functions and responsibilities of this authority was that it will act as the planning, coordinating and implementing body for disaster management at the district level, and it will take all the necessary measures for the purpose of disaster management in accordance with the guidelines laid down by the National Disaster Management Act. It will prepare the district disaster management plan for the district, and it will also monitor the implementation of the national policies. Fourth, National Disaster Response Force. It is led by a Director General appointed by the central government. It is a specialized force constituted for the purpose of specialist response to a threatening disaster situation under the Disaster Management Act 2005. Various functions and responsibilities of this force were: it conducted research, rescue operations in the event of any natural catastrophe, but It also helps us to fight with all the natural disasters, including biological, chemical, radiological. Fifth, National Executive Committee. It is constituted under Section 8 of Disaster Management Act 2005 to assist the national authority in the performance of its functions. Union Home Secretary is its ex officio chairperson of the National Executive Committee. Various key functions and responsibilities that were important for the committee to perform were: it acts as coordinating and monitoring body for disaster management. It also prepared national plans which were to be approved by the national authority. It promotes general education and awareness in relation to disaster management. This act has provided us the legal and institutional framework for disaster management in India at all the three levels, that is, district, state and national level. In the Federal Polity of India, the primary responsibility of this act rests with the state government. Progress and achievements were there which was being made by this act world. It runs intensive earthquake and extreme weather events awareness campaigns and provides guidelines regarding natural and man-made disaster. It also cooperates with the agencies at national and international levels only and only to save the lives of humans. Cyclone Fani, one of the worst cyclones to hit India in last two decades. You all must be aware of this fact. Odisha's preparedness, efficient early warning system, well-planned large-scale evacuations that only helped people move safely into the cyclone shelters. Otherwise, what would be the end result? That is the loss of human life. Similarly, Andhra Pradesh demonstrated an equally excellent evacuation strategy for millions during cyclone in 2014. Detailed directions to guide disaster management efforts. But of course, shortcomings were also there of this act. The NDRF personnel lacks sufficient training and equipment facilities, accommodation to tackle the crisis situation properly. The act largely focuses on improving preparedness, immediate relief, but it neglected the long-term recovery, which was an important fact to be kept in mind. Misutilization of funds can be seen in many sectors. Government constituted National Disaster Response Fund, State Disaster Response Fund to deal with the disasters. Audit findings reveal that some states have misutilized the funds for expenditures that were not sanctioned for disaster management. There was also the absence of declaration of disaster-prone zones. During the Uttarakhand flooding in 2018, the NDMA failed to timely inform the people about the flash floods and landslides. The post-disaster relief response had been equally poor. Experts blamed the poor planning of NDMA that led to unfinished projects for flood and landslide mitigation.
I hope you liked the video. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more updates and stay tuned for more information. To know more about law informants, click on the link given in the description box.